नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवीएस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, गवर्नमेंट यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द माइक्रोबियल फ्लोरा ऑफ माउथ और ओरल। सो दिस इज अ प्रैक्टिकल सेशन एंड वी विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ टू डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट द माइक्रोबियल फ्लोरा ऑफ माउथ और ओरल माइक्रोबियल फ्लोरा। दिस बिलोंग्स टू द सब्जेक्ट मेडिकल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी लैब। So there are microbes which are present in our oral cavity or mouth. So the presence, because the presence of the nutrients, the epithelial debris and the secretions makes the mouth a favorable habitat for a variety of the microbes. And in that, because when we eat, the particles are remains in our oral cavity, moisture is already available there, and the temperature is also there. So it makes a place to grow the microbes. So the various types of the microbes or bacteria are present in our oral cavity, and the microbes which are present there are the streptococci, lactobacilli, and the corynebacteria. So the great number of anaerobes, specifically the bacteroids, are also present there. So because the mouth presents a succession of different ecological situations with age, and this corresponds with changes in the composition of the normal flora. Because the physiology changes, so the ecological component of our mouth for the bacteria or for the microbe is changing as the time is passing. In the newborn, the mouth cavity is composed of the soft tissues of the lips, cheeks, tongue, and palate. And moisture is there by the secretions of the salivary glands. At the birth, the oral cavity is very much sterile, but it becomes colonized when the time is passing and the environment is changing, particularly when it feeds on the milk. The specific bacteria, Streptococcus salivaris, is present there, and they make up around 98% of the oral flora until the teeth are come. So at the age of 6 to 9 months, when the teeth are there, the composition is changed. Because the eruption of the teeth during the first year, it makes the colonization of the Streptococcus mutans and the S. sanguis. These bacteria require non-descumating or non-epithelium surface in order to colonize. So they will present there as teeth remains. So the other types of the bacteria or other strains of the Streptococci present there and in the gums and cheeks, but not to the teeth. So the creation of the gingival cervici are that is the supporting structure of the teeth. Though the gingival cervici area it increases the variety of the different category of the species, that is the anaerobes. There are a complex flora continues to increase with time, and bacterioids and the spirochetes colonize in the middle, before middle age, that is the around 10 to 15 years. So the normal flora of the oral cavity, they do not always create the trouble. Okay, so there are many bacteria that are helpful, they are beneficial for the person, and they provides the nutrients and habitat, vice versa to the bacteria. So there are there may be benefits as well to the host. The normal flora occupy the available colonization sites, which makes it more difficult for other microorganisms. So the pathogens are not able to grow there because there are already the normal flora is there. So they compete to them and they makes us healthy. Because the pathogens are not growing there, they are not able to grow there. So that are beneficial to us, and they get the nutrition and the habitat from us. So the this is a symbiosis type of the situation. The oral flora, they contribute to human nutrition through the synthesis of various types of the vitamins, and they contribute to the immunity by inducing the low levels of circulating and secretory antibodies that may cross react with the pathogens. Because they are microbes, they have some low level of the immune reactions in our body. So against them, our body produces base level of the antibodies that are helpful to fight against the pathogens which may occur, which may infect us. Secondly, the oral flora are the usual cause of various oral diseases in humans. Okay, so generally they do not cause the diseases, but sometimes when the immunity is weak, they can cause the different types of the diseases, such as the abscesses, dental caries, the gingivitis, and the other types of the dental problems. If oral bacteria can gain entrance into the deeper tissues, they may cause abscession of the alveolar bone, lung, brain, and in the extremities. So in the infections, in the case of the infection, there are a mixture of bacteria that creates a situation, like the bacterioids, melanogenicus often playing a dominant role. If oral streptococci are introduced into wounds created by a dental manipulation or treatment, they may adhere to heart walls and initiate the subacute bacterial endocarditis. So this was the basic information regarding the oral flora, normal oral flora, the different types of the microbes, and the physiology. Now, what is the principle of the experiment? So why the flora are present there? Because we have already discussed that they are, when we feed on something, when we consume any of the food material, so some particles remains there. So the presence of the nutrients, or the presence of the epithelial debris, and different types of the secretions which are generated by the mouth itself, they create a habituation, they create a space for the bacteria to grow. Okay, so the bacteria such as the lactobacilli, staphylococci, streptococci, and cornibacteria, and the various other types of the anaerobes, they grow there. So the mouth presents a succession of different ecological situations, and with the age, it changes the ecosystem for the microbes. The variety of microbes changes as the age passes. Okay. There are benefits, there are losses to the bacteria, to us, and that's why the study is required and for demonstration of the microbes present in the oral cavity. So to perform the experiment and the presentation or the demonstration of the oral cavity bacteria, we need some materials, and the material requires are the inocula from the various body sites, and here the site is the oral cavity. Okay, so in the oral cavity we can take the sample from the teeth, from the tongue, from the epithelial wall of the inner epithelial wall of the cheeks. So these may be the different sites in the body, in the mouth. Then we need the culture media, and we can take the PDA, potato dextrose agar, if we want to see the fungus, or we can use the nutrient agar media if we want to demonstrate the bacterial population in the mouth. Then we need the incubator to culture or to grow the microbes. We need a laminar airflow for the inoculation and the other experiments to be performed in a sterile condition. We need a nichrome vial loop to make the suspension to stick the sample on the media plates, culture media plates. We need the ethanol, 70% ethanol to make the things sterilized, to make the hand sterilized, to surface sterilization. We need the cotton and the autoclave to sterilize the reagents, to sterilize the media and other glasswares and materials which are required during the experiment. How to proceed? What are the steps? What is the procedure of the experiment? So first of all, prepare the culture media for the bacteria as well as for the fungal growth. Okay, so the nutrient agar and potato dextrose agar respectively for the bacteria and the fungus. After preparation, we sterilize it using the autoclave and pour the autoclaved media into the culture plates in a sterile condition using the laminar airflow. After pouring, we will wait for the solidification of the media. When the media is solidified, prepare the inocula using the samples isolated from the mouth, from the various sites, for such as from the teeth, tongue, and the cheeks. Then we stick before sticking. When you isolated the sample from the mouth, we will dissolve it or mix it in a sterile saline solution. After the solution is prepared, stick on the different plates, marking the site of the mouth. Say three plates are there for the nutrient agar, and three plates are there for the PDA, and mark on them such as the teeth, the cheeks, and the tongue. and stick the sample on the plates and place it in the incubator and observe after 24 hour, and if the growth is not there in the 24 hour, wait for the 48 hour and observe which type of the colonies are there, which type of bacteria are there, which type of fungus are there. So the observation you can see, you can observe the bacteria using the characteristics of the morphology of the colony. So colony or morphology can be observed. If the confusion is there, you can observe the bacteria and fungus on the using the microscope. You can do the microscopy, or the biochemical test may be performed for checking the presence of a specific type of the bacterial or the fungal populations. Otherwise, the colony morphology or the microscopy is sufficient. Okay, so this was all about the demonstration of the microbial flora of the mouth. Hope you are satisfied with this detailed session. If you have any doubt, any query, you can write in the comment box. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.